Flashback to about 2 months ago, when I published the very first iteration of enchantment manipulation in a version before release 1.8. It did its job, but was quite limited, only working in single player from beta 1.9 pre-release 4 to 1.2.5. That changes today. The new version of my tool includes two brand new methods to allow for the enchantment RNG seed to be cracked not only in both single player and multiplayer, but also in every version from beta 1.9 pre-release 4 to release 1.7.10. So to begin the tutorial on how to use this tool, we will start off in the famous version, beta 1.9 pre-release 4, that added enchanting. So you will need to make a setup like this if you are in a version below 1.3 with 30 bookshelves in this format. And then we can pull up the tool and in the setup choose our version, which is beta 1.9 pre-release 4, and we have 30 bookshelves. And this is the first method, the Galactic Cracker, which will only work in single player, but is much faster than the multiplayer method. So if you're in single player, use this one. So to start, take one of your tools that you're going to be enchanting and place it into the table. And now we need to look at the standard galactic text here and match it up with the numbers on these on this chart here. And you can see that the chart only really includes the first characters of the different words that exist, but this can help you speed up the search process, as you just need to look at the first characters. And you also need to mark if the line has four words or three. In this case, all of them are three, so we will not check any of these boxes. But for this, as an example, we will look at this first word here. You can see it's a little lightning bolt character and a little sideways slash, which lines up with this 20 right over here. So we'll just enter that, and then we have to repeat that for all the words. And after we've done that, then we can enter the levels, which are displayed here in green text. And then we can press crack RNG. And see the tool has spit out our RNG seed, but we can just go to the manipulator tab now and select what we are enchanting. So a pickaxe of tool gold. And select our enchants that we want, and you can see that the tool says that we need to perform 7 advances. So to do that, all we do is we pick up and put the tool down 7 times. And you can see that the levels will match up with the tool's prediction. If they do not match here, then you have done something wrong and you shouldn't waste your levels. So, slot 3. And there's our tool. Now there are a few more options on this page that aren't really explained in the previous video. There's an exactly button here that if you tick only the enchantments that you've selected here will be matched. There will be no extra enchantments, because if you don't have this checked, other enchantments, such as, for example, Silk Touch, could also be applied. But if you check exactly, only these enchantments will be found. And the next setting, which can allow you to get higher level enchantments quicker, is Advanced Advances. Now, in this basic version of the tool, you can see that if you're looking for high-level enchantments, you might have to advance a few times. And advanced advances can allow you to perform less advancements to get what you want. Now, I forgot to tell the tool that we enchanted successfully. So, important step. Hit the enchantment done button when you're done enchanting. So, if you are going to use advanced advances, you'll need to have a little additional preparation. Instead of having just the item you're going to enchant, you need to have two of that item, and then a dummy item as well. Although, you rarely need this second item, so if you are a little short on diamonds, you can leave it out. So, let's look for some rare enchants. Okay, so there's a few different instructions here on what you need to do. So you can start by placing your item back in, because we've performed an enchantment already. Now, swap different means that we need to take another enchantable item that is a different item than the item we're enchanting, and click on the slot that many times, so in this case 30 times. Okay, now we need to shift remove and insert the item. So shift click to remove is the important step, but you can just place it back in. And then out in just means pick it up and put it back down. And you can see the levels match up. Slot 3. And our enchantment is done. So now we need to cover the multiplayer method of cracking the RNG before release 1.3. Now this method is pretty slow and a little more complicated. You can also do it in single player, which I will do for the sake of demonstration. This method, which I have nicknamed the extreme method, requires locating level 50 enchantments due to reasons I'm not going to elaborate on. You also can find level 1 enchantments as the counterpart to level 50, because you're trying to find the extreme values that the enchanting table can produce for levels. Now, you can either look for these by hand and count the number of pages in between and mark if the number is the low number or the high number, or you can use the auto search function. Now, to use this function, if you're on Windows, you can use the alt print screen method, which is a lot easier and doesn't require tedious setup. So to use this method, you'll need to make sure that the game is in the size that the game launches in by default. That's important. But if your game is that size, then you just need to have your item in the window. Click Enable Auto Searcher. And you can see that there are some instructions that are spit out in the tool here. So you need to make sure that your MC window is to the default size and GUI size 2. And then place your item into the enchanting slot, hover over it with your mouse, and then press Control to start the auto search. And some other information that is important if you're on a multiplayer server or are having issues with the tool is you can increase the search delay in milliseconds, which is a delay in between cycling the enchanting table. So if you have a high ping on a server, you will likely need to increase that number. And also the PRSC attempts, or print screen attempts. So if you're getting errors such as failed to retrieve screenshot from clipboard, you can increase that number. If you are on Windows, you will need to make sure that the print screen button has its original functionality enabled and is not set to open the snipping tool, which I don't know where that setting is, but I know you can Google it. So now it's just a waiting game to allow the tool to gather the information it needs to gather. And there are also a few additional options to the auto searcher, as it basically controls your mouse while it's running. If you press P, you can pause the Finder, and if you press P again, you can unpause it, so in case you, for say, get a Discord message and need to answer it. And if something is going really wrong, and it's providing input to other programs when you're trying to move your mouse, you can press the spacebar, and that will completely stop it. Now that the tool has finished collecting the data, we can then press the crack RNG button. And it has spit out our seed. And then you would use the manipulator page exactly as you would if you'd used the Galactic Cracker. Now, if the alt print screen method is causing you problems, you can also use the robot method, which will work on operating systems other than Windows. So to begin, you'll need to take a screenshot of your entire desktop environment. In this case, I will do so by pressing print screen. Now we will need to use some application to then look at this screenshot. And we need to make sure our MC window is in GUI size 2. And then we need to locate this pixel right here. Actually, no, not right there. That's wrong. We need to locate the pixel that is right here, as this will be the beginning of the number for the third tab here. So this pixel, we then need to get its coordinates. You can see in the bottom corner, it is at 745, 520. So we need to enter that, 745, 520. And then if we enable the auto searcher, and we need to make sure now not to move this window. And then if we were to run the auto searcher, it would also work. Just run it for a tad little bit to prove that, you know, it works. So now let's move on to the third way to crack the enchantment RNG that will be used in 1.3 and above. So let's open 1.3. And you will need to make a slightly different setup to allow this method to work. So you will need to build this setup here and make sure there's a water bucket in this dispenser and not have loose animals running around. So to begin, you will need to put 7 torches here around the enchanting table. And then you will need to stand lined up against this fence gate and trap door, and then click right here on the corner of the enchanting table. And of course, select our version, and we're in 1.3.2. 15 shelves. And now you will start by just putting in an item into the table. And you can see the levels are 1, 5, and 3. Enter that there. And pick up and put the item down again. 1, 6, 2. And so on and so forth. So now you can press the crack RNG button. And then, of course, use the manipulator tab. But how do we get our bookshelves to be activated? Because right now our table is currently has all the bookshelves blocked. Well, with this setup we've made, you can simply drop an item to the side of the window to activate and deactivate the dispenser. So now all the torches have been flushed away, and if we put our item back into the table, the full level 30 enchantment is available for our Enchantment needs. Now, there is something important that one must keep in mind if they are enchanting in 1.5.2, well, 1.5 and above. Because 1.5 added a new method of moving items that I will demonstrate really quickly. That if you have, say, a stack of items, you can drag it like such. But if you have a single item and you hold the mouse button down and drag it around, this is a different kind of placement of the item than if you pick it straight up and straight down. And if you are in the table, you can accidentally drag the item, which will apply a different amount of advances to the enchantment RNG, which will screw up the tool. So you need to be very careful to make sure you do not do this and click the tool straight up and straight down without drag clicking. So if you're having problems in 1.5 and above, this is probably why. But that pretty much concludes this tutorial on the tool, so I hope you enjoy. I know I certainly enjoyed making it, and I'll hopefully see you in the book video that is about 6+ months late. So, see you later.